Brothers Grimm story, which actually does feature the little people. This is quite unusual. It has more of the feel of a kind of Irish leprechaun story than anything else. There was a goldsmith and a tailor, and they decided that they would have a better life in the neighbouring city. So they set off together to head for the city looking for more work. And as they were walking one night, and they're looking for somewhere to sleep, they heard some beautiful music. And almost against their will, they were drawn towards the sound of the beautiful music. And they walked through a field and they found a circle of little people, some men, some women, holding hands and dancing and singing. And it was their singing that was the beautiful music that had drawn the goldsmith and the tailor to the field. And there in the middle was an old man, as small as the rest, with a long beard. And the fire was blazing. So the goldsmith and the tailor joined in the circle and began to dance. And then, when the singing and the dancing came to an end just before dawn, they went over to the old man and he pulled a knife from his belt. And before they realised what had happened, the tailor and the goldsmith had both had their beards shaved off and they had both had all their hair shaved off. And then the old man gestured to them to a pile of coal nearby, and they realized that he meant for them to take some coal, and so they placed it in the pockets of their coats. So that night, the tailor and the goldsmith slept in an inn. Now, the goldsmith was a crookback. He had a hump. It's been difficult for him to sleep. But in the morning, when the tailor and the goldsmith looked in the pockets of their coats, where they expected there to be lumps of black coal, there was gold, big nuggets of gold. So the tailor said, "Now I can set myself up as a master tailor and I can marry my sweetheart." The goldsmith, the hunchback, who was a greedy man, said, "Tonight I will go back to the field and I will see if I can find the little people and take some more of their coal. I would like more gold." And as he ran his hand over his hair, he realized that his hair had all grown back and his beard had all grown back. And he looked at his friend the tailor and realized that his hair and his beard had grown back. So, there. That night, because the goldsmith wanted to go back to the field and search for the little people, the tailor decided to go with his friend. And the same thing happened. And the goldsmith took more coal, but the tailor thought, "I I have enough gold, I don't need any more. So the two of them went back to the same inn. And the next morning, when the goldsmith looked through his pockets, he found nothing but coal. And when he ran his hand over his head, he found that he was as bald as an egg, and his hair never grew back. For the rest of his life, he had to wear hats. And he found that his beard had gone, and it never grew back. And he found that as well as the hump on his back, he had a hump on his front. So the goldsmith, for his greed, ended up with coal and an extra hump. The tailor went home to his sweetheart, set up a little business as a master tailor, and married his true love. And I like to think that they, are you ready? This is your line. You know your line. They, come on, lived happily ever after and were always grateful to the little people for the gift of their gold. So perhaps every time they lit a fire and put coal on the fire, they remembered the gift of the coal that was really gold from the little people. And I suppose we must say that they were fairy folk, mustn't we? Hope to see you again soon. More Brothers Grimm stories on my channel. See you soon.